Hello and welcome back to The Pulse. We're so excited to be back in 2023, and to kick off our new year, we're going to talk about getting around on two wheels. So, without further ado and giving away too much, let's jump into it. Aaron was mentioning last time an electric bike rental system called Lime in Vancouver and surrounding areas. Aaron, do you know much about that program?
Well, for one thing, it's electric scooters and bikes.
Okay.
I came across it when I visited my sister for a family event. She and I and a group of her girlfriends were hanging out during the night and later spent the night in a hotel. But at one point, we came across these electric scooters. We were on our way back from the bar that we were at, and about half of us got onto the electric scooters and used it to get back to the hotel. It was actually quite fun. And it's the same program. It's called Lime. That's like the fruit, L-I-M-E. And through the app, you can either like reserve in advance, or you could pay with like your credit card or PayPal, or set up an account. So you can how you would Starbucks, you can have a balance on your card and just use that and just refill it as you need to. And you would use that app to unlock, I guess, for me, my recent experience was with the scooter. You would use it to unlock the scooter. You can use it to notify if there were any like issues or mechanical problems, and you can use it within an area. And if I remember correctly, you have to, if you need to take a pause for like a brief pause where you like to need to step out and buy a cup of coffee or something, you can actually pause your ride for a brief period of time. But they also mentioned that you need to be sort of in like a designated parking area or something. It was interesting to use. Fair warning, they are a little heavy to use and move and maneuver. So if you don't have very much in arm strength, just be careful of that.
Yeah, when I needed more flexibility for travel, but I wasn't quite ready to start trying to drive a car yet, I purchased a scooter and I drove that for 4 years before I got my L. And I found it was a really good way to learn the rules of the road and the things that I needed to watch out for, and it was really good because I tried to get my license first time when I was 16, but I found going at the speed of a car trying to process everything all at once was really, really difficult. So I got to learn all of the things that I needed to process at a slower speed on my electric scooter, which was really, really nice.
If you're looking at transit, can you afford to rent one of those things every day, or is it cheaper to take like a bus?
I would say cheaper to take the bus, because you'd have to be like a one ride thing, and you have to make sure you can return it into a designated areas.
Yeah.
So if where you're going is not in there, it's not like you can borrow it for a night or something.
Right.
You'd be charged for that whole period of time. It is $1.15 to start, and then 35 cents per minute plus tax. So I think the first time you try it, you get like 10 minutes free or something.
It's nice, too, with scooters that you're kind of removed from traffic a little bit in most areas, because with the electric scooters, you drive where bikes drive. So you get to use the bike lanes and you get to be a little bit removed while you're kind of learning things and figuring out all of the different hazards that you could come in contact with. People walking down the road on their phone.
When it comes to like riding a bike, you get to learn a little bit of the road safety as a bike user.
Yeah.
And you just expand that more when you study to learn how to drive.
Okay, so here's a question. What if you're not able to ride a bike? What if that's just something that's not a part of your life, or something that you're physically not able to do? Let's say you're in a wheelchair, you use a wheelchair for mobility. You can't hop on a bike and figure that out. So what's a good alternative?
Well, I know like with the electric kind of like moped type scooters, there are ones that are made more for people who are wheelchair users. And they have 3 or 4 wheels, depending on the style that you get.
Sweet.
And also, if you just don't have the balance to use a bike for whatever reason, you can get one that's more like a electric kind of moped type scooter, but has 3 wheels. So you don't have to worry as much about the balance.
That's cool.
You just kind of have to shop around to find the different things.
Yeah.
But I know that there are options when it comes to that, so that could be helpful. There are hand pedal bikes. Yeah, there's three-wheel hand pedal bikes out there that you can use. So if somebody who is a wheelchair user who has the use of their hands, I mean, for most of these things, you need at least the use of your hands, then you can use the hand pedal bikes.
That's so cool.
Yeah, there's so much cool things people sort of think outside the box. You know, it's really trying to not like reinventing the wheel, but in a sense, a lot of people are trying to really rethink how we go around in society.
That does it for today's episode of The Pulse. We really hope you found it interesting. Come back next week when we talk about community access and transportation. As always, if you have questions you'd like us to discuss, or if you want to be a guest on the show, send an email to voa@pacificautismfamily.com. We look forward to more of these great questions. Thanks for listening.